Time for weapons testing. In the old Hunters DLC, I picked up two new interesting items. It's a boom hammer and amygdalan arm. Wow. Now, neither of these is powerfully fortified, and neither of them is particularly well adapted to my stats. They both seem to be more strength weapons than anything else, so don't expect enormous damage output here. But I want to see their movesets. I've come to the Witch's Abode in Hemwick Charnel Lane, largely because there are lots of executioner enemies here. Big fat guys who are good to test weapons on, so I'll hit them hard, and who also drop blood vials. I would like to stock up on those. So first of all, we've got this boom hammer. It's got a sort of explosive head trigger system there. In basic use, it's a hammer. Cool. Big, heavy, slow. What about? Yep. And is there a rolling attack? Yes, there is. A slightly faster swing. Oh, wait, there's a running attack, actually. Actually, that might not be any different to the standard one. Yeah, it's not. That. Okay, nothing really special about those attacks. So presumably it's the trick form of the weapon which is interesting. It's the same thing, but on fire. Nice. So its discharge then does extra damage. Presumably that's why it's a fire damage weapon. Was there someone here? Okay, so first of all let's try it unbuffed. Not used to the time. 148 fire damage. I've put blood gems on it, which mean it does mostly fire damage, I think. Which is, again, not a great way to get this damage up, but it's a cool gimmick. So that's 148 if I just do an R1 swing for one of these guys. That was more. It might be a weaker one. Fire indeed. Oh, they don't like fire. Alright, so let's do one of these buffed swings. It doesn't seem to cost anything. It doesn't cost any bullets. Does it then have all the same attacks? Oh yeah, it looks like it. What about a transform attack if I do this? Ah, then you do an immediate... Nice. So there's a combo there, where you can basically get a long series of fire attacks. Very stamina costly, though. Okay, so let's see how much damage I can do with these. Although, unfortunately, my test bed enemy is gone now. Oh, no, there's more. Same ones, actually. Yeah, no, it definitely did more damage. So what if I was to deal? It's moderately effective. In its current state of fortification and gemming and so on, even in fire mode, the damage is not amazing. It might be even less amazing on these guys. Yeah. Still is cool. How about charge up? What? I guess they're particularly strong against that kind of attack, huh? What if I... What if I do this? Nope. That didn't work out for me. Okay, I better get decapitated. Oh shit. I'm going to get decapitated, I guess. But, you know, not fatally. Well, that's interesting. It's a cool gimmick. You would get into a real rhythm style thing with it. But unless I actually want to do fire damage in particular, which you sometimes do, I don't know, the fact that I don't have the stats for it, like, this thing is, B scaling on strength, E on skill. I've got, like, 18 strength and 50 skill. Of course, the other weapon has the same issue, but it looks cool as well, so let's try it out anyway. Anyway, the Amygdalan Arm. This will do even less damage, as it is, but is it really the arm of an amygdala? Great. Well, it says so. So it's like a club. Yep, that's like a club. Uh-huh. Faster. Yeah, good roll attack. Okay, and some, as long as it does lots of damage, that's okay, that moveset. Let's try it out on someone. Though of course it won't work super well. Yeah, stuff about low damage, etc. You know the drill. Where is another executioner? Here's one. Come on. Come to Silas. I've attracted one. Don't want to fight two at once. Come on. Stop. That made him angry. No. Rain gun is not that good in standard form. Thirty-one damage. Unfortunately, that seems to be the damage type which these guys are particularly strong against. Yeah, that's blunt, I assume. Can't really blunt them. Okay, I'm running away. I'm gonna have to try out. I'm either gonna have to fight some different enemies, or try out its trick form. Whoa! That was an interestingly organic transformation. How does this attack? That was cool. Looks like quite a bit of range. Those were unpredictable. Right to left, left to right. Up and down. Is that a four attack cycle? Up to the stack. Yeah. How about... That's interesting. Multiple attacks. Oh, wow. The arm keeps going. Okay, let's try that out and hope it's a different damage type. I tried to use the long slow attack, didn't quite get it off in time. Interesting. A sort of poise break happened there. That's cool. Kind of hard to use, but I definitely see the potential. Next up. Trying to use the big slow attack to work out. Let's try a long one. There we go. Yeah, that's got some range on it. I think it might have the largest hitbox of any weapon I've used. Huh? What? But Those horses don't look well. Okay. Padded doors. Well, at least there are some living horses left in the... Well, I... Maybe I shouldn't be so quick to pass judgment on that. Oh, I know what this is. Yeah, I got a letter saying... Oh! Dogs. Okay, I think I'm going to switch back to the weapons I have the stats for, because I think I know what this is. This is the Kinghurst summons that I picked up. It said to come to Hemwick, and I am in Hemwick, and I am being summoned. Ride carriage. What is watching me through this bush? It's going towards the broken bridge. And this is where the game cuts to, like, yeah, you've fallen into the ocean. There's no path onwards, sorry. It's fine, apparently. Yeah, I suspect these horses are only moving thanks to regular drafts of blood. That's a heck of a castle. Regular here. So this place is outside of normal rules to some extent. Forsaken Kinghurst Castle. Yeah, that... I'm not quite sure how the carriage made it across here. Cool. Well, I don't actually... I was in the middle of exploring the DLC, but... I don't have a lamp, so I guess I continue onwards. And hopefully I'll find one. So, summary of the weapons I was testing. I don't really care for the big boom hammer enough to do any stat changes and investments for it. The amygdalin arm I like. I could see myself trying that out more. Seems interesting for PvP since it's got such a weird moveset. And I guess I do have a lamp after all. This looks cool. A lot of statues of rich people. Spectre. Ah. It's a terrible pit in the ground. Little chapel thing. I think... I want to get back to the Hunter's Nightmare, though. My device is not currently operable. Device is not currently operatic. Oh, I would like that treasure. If I get it, will I die? Maybe. Maybe not, though. Take too much damage. Dunk it. Beautiful. Ah. Wow, these four almost saved my life there. I nearly succeeded there. That was almost cool. Okay, I don't care too much about 10,000 blood money. That's like a trivial amount. And I want to continue evaluating whether I should be continuing to do the Hunter's Nightmare. So, I'm leaving, but I'll come back here. That's a cool place. I don't need your blood money. Hurst Castle. I wonder what role it plays. Hello. That's not the correct nightmare headstone I want. This one. All these other glowing ones are chalice dungeons. Let me give you a brief overview. I haven't been televising this stuff because they're just dungeon crawls, right? But there was the Thumerian Labyrinth, the original chalice dungeon, which you did see on TV, or on whatever medium you're using to experience this let's play, I guess. Then that led to the central Thumeru chalice, and that led further on to the Hintertomb chalice, and to the lower Thumeru chalice, and the lower Hintertomb chalice. I have not completed this one, and I have not completed this. I'm partway through those. Further, I do have another chalice. These root chalices make random dungeons. You get them partway through the non-root ones, right? So you can see I've finished central Thumeru because I've got the root for it. Haven't finished lower Thumeru. Similarly, I finished Hintertomb, but not lower Hintertomb. I also have this Loran chalice, Ealing Loran, which I got from destroying the Amygdala in the Nightmare Frontier. But I can't use it yet. It requires some extremely powerful ritual blood. I need 9 of that stuff. I've got 2, not 9. Cold blood flower buds are not such a big deal. You can buy those with insight. I don't really want to spend insight on them, but you can. That concludes our tour of the state of the chalice situation. What I have been doing in the chalice dungeons, I haven't been recording and commentating them, but I have been saving the video of boss fights in particular. So, at some point, I don't know how far through the chalice sequence I'll make it. It's not compelling enough to do the whole thing, basically. Well, I don't know. I think it would require you to be in New Game Plus or something anyway. But I will at least sequence together those things into a video of some sort at some point. This is it. The Hunter's Nightmare. Alternate vision of Yharnam, where blood-drunk hunters hunt cowering beasts. I believe that if I go this way... I believe if I go that way, that is in fact the one place I have not explored. So let's get to it. I picked up a bunch of blood chunks in the cave of the blood-starved beast who I cruelly and unfairly defeated. And also the Gatling gun hunters who I absolutely legitimately defeated. So it was that. And unfortunately, turns out I didn't quite have enough blood chunks to upgrade either my threaded cane or my sword spear any further. So I need like one more, I think. I'm as damaging as I was before, which seems to be potentially adequate. Ugh, a lot of blood sacks here. Don't really want to fight them, they're just annoying. That one that ran over here, will it run back? If not, I could just walk further in, but it might come up behind me. Ah, I don't care about fighting one of them, if that happens. Alright, the cool slap sound of walking on blooded male boots. What's all this then? A gate. The way is barred. Probably a good thing. Oh, hello, oh! Oh! I missed! shoot at dogs you want to actually hit. Can I go into these buildings? Not that one anyway. Oh, there's something over here though. Frenzied cold blood. I noticed recently that all the different cold bloods have different item descriptions on them. Some of them, of course, provide lore hints. This manifestation of madness comes from a mind teetering on the very brink. But has a sane mind ever produced anything of true significance? That, I think, is a hint as to the nature of insight. Might as well be called madness. Oh. Someone's there. At least the dogs in this place aren't particularly tough. Oh! Oh shit. So, it's one of those guys. Now, if I am on point, I should be able to defeat him. But the bird doesn't make it easier. In fact, the bird makes it harder. The way of thinking about their defenses and attacks, which I hit upon a couple episodes ago, really helps there. I can reliably kill that type of enemy now, which is good. In retrospect, like, it sounds really dumb and obvious. The secret is essentially dodge their attacks. And then, like, after dodging, hit them. Then, once you've hit them enough that they're going to start attacking again, start dodging. It's maybe not an amazing revelation. But somehow I haven't really got the idea of it at first. So are these piles of corpses coming to life to destroy me? I mean, obviously they are. Which is the sort of thing that would happen, right? I like the Hunter's Nightmare. It's gory. Kind of like New Londo with the water drained, except there's blood and death. So, yeah, there's like walls of flesh. Ah, I'm on the other side of the gate. It doesn't open, does it? Oh. I keep wondering if I had to, like, wake up. Did I miss a path, though? How do I get to that thing, is my question. I'm not sure I've explored every avenue. I think I actually have, though. Oh, no, I haven't. I thought there was something I forgot about. This. I didn't climb the... Come on! Obviously you can walk up that. I was like leaving it to last because it was so clear that it was like the way to go. Are you telling me I can't walk up this inclined slope? This gentle incline is like 35 degrees at most. Like, you clearly start ascending it and then there's an invisible barrier or something. They had to break the normal physics to prevent you from climbing it. Gosh. Okay, I'll go up this ladder instead. Where am I now? I mean, if this was Yharnam. Nothing's attacked me immediately, so I'll probably have a moment to get my bearings. Would these have been part of the sewer? Oh, and how do I get down there also? Gah. Okay, this is making me mad. You clearly can claim it, right? Like, you claim up that and then you walk over there and you get that treasure and you jump down and get the other treasure. Obviously that's how you do it, except it's apparently not. Apparently there's something else. Like, walking across the planks? Yeah. Yeah. I'm glad jumping puzzle instincts have not totally failed me here. Constable's garb. Interesting. Will I be able to get there? Not this way, I think. That may have to wait. Could have gone over there also. Perhaps I shall. So the constable's gloves were pretty okay looking gloves with very good stats. Perhaps the constable's garb will also be good. Here's my concern. My current chest slot item is the best. Look at this. Look at my crew for the cape and the way it meshes with the bone mail armor and the bone ash armor and the sort of bone ash leggings. Like, how can you possibly compete with that? I'll check it out. Oh, thank goodness, it's not very good. Oh, it's got great defenses against magic, I guess. Whatever. Once upon a time, a troop of foreign constables chased a beast all the way to Yharnam, and this is what they wore. They became victims except for one survivor who devoured the creature whole. Fable among Yharnamites. Yes, I think I want to go down there. Clearly so. How is the blood up here? Oh, it's a nightmare, I guess. It doesn't actually have any physical sense. Oh, I somehow didn't notice that until it happened to me. For some reason, it seems like the camera in this area is really zoomed out and it's throwing me the hell off. Like, holy shit. Okay, I don't know why everything is so zoomed out. I probably could have killed that guy under normal circumstances, I like to think. Let's go and try it again. Ugh. I don't know if I can get there very quickly, though. Maybe I can. So, where's the door? There it is. Okay. Here's the deal. I'm pretty sure that was a kind of hunter I've faced before. Okay, but also look at this. Like, look at like the rough zoom level there. That's normal, right? Silas's hat, if there's no particular constraint on the camera, is like a little over halfway up the screen. My contention is that the camera was fucking with me there. I intend to prove it. Very well-aimed series of attacks. Now, I believe the second guy is going to... Yeah, that guy scuttles over him. Once he's gone, then it's safe from... Oh, wait a minute. Okay, I'm going early. Yeah, I'm going. Bye. I'm gone. Maybe I shouldn't have left them all behind me, because now how do I get back? Well, you know what? That probably won't be a concern. That's my feeling, unfortunately. If I get to that point, I'll be happy. This guy. Will I? No, he's around the corner. I don't have to. That's good news. Oh, wait, no, he's right there. Ha! Huh. I was completely wrong. And then I got hit by his armor attack. Let's improve the situation. Improvement at all. It's like something directly into his chest. Didn't improve anything for anybody. Not even this guy. He's like trapped in a nightmare of his own making because he's gone mad with blood. Not really possible to improve his life other than by ending it, so I failed that. Well, I could run past some of that stuff. The birds make me think I probably couldn't get to the ladder and climb it without, at the very least, the hunter shooting at me. So I probably do need to kill most of them, sadly. Let's do this the easy way. The easy way actually involves more fighting than the hard way. Kill that guy, which is simple. This guy likewise. If I take these guys on one at a time, there's no problem with any of them. And having done all this... What? One of the beasts is here. That's not what I wanted. Oh shit. The hunter must have fallen on it. And it's vanished now. It's fallen through the world. Huh. That problem took care of itself. Okay, so I want to get over here. I want to wait for a guy to come scuttling out of there. Go on. There you go. Now that he's clumped up with all the others, I can cross this area safely. Cool. And that takes me back to the gate and the ladder and the blood and the bridges. It sounds mythical, doesn't it? Or mythological. The gate and the ladder and the blood and the bridges. Come on, if you think you're bird enough. I guess he absolutely was. You. Nope. I locked onto the wrong target. A bird on the rafters above. Nope. That's what I was going for. Oh dear. It'll work out in the end. I don't know how I didn't get the parry there. I mean, I didn't get the visceral. I got the stagger, but... Yeah. Whip really is the best tool that this guy's gonna do. It gets them in the air. Like, if they start flying at you, the whip brings them down. I'm not using it really, like, efficiently here. But, particularly in a one-on-one situation, you start doing that and the bird rises, you still hit it. Okay. Back to progression. Or maybe not. I mean, I could go up here, which seems like... What was that?
A bell. Yeah, that's clearly one of the cathedrals. This is like where to go and stuff within the dream. Discover these awful secrets.
But down here is a guy who killed me. I'd like to return the favor. I can't even see him. It's camouflage somehow. Falls effective but reeks of hunter. Where is that mysterious man? Could somebody freeze frame this? Do you want to like pause the video and tell me where's Waldo? I don't know. Still don't know. And yeah, I've definitely more zoomed out. Look at this, look, the top of Silas's hat is now like well below the center of the screen. I don't know what's up with that. I don't like it. There he is.
More blood.
Fuck you. Less blood. We've all had too much blood, for fuck's sake. Blood is the problem at this point. Okay, I got a little over-eager there. Damn it.
Why haven't I given up at God somewhere else? The answer is because inadvertently Dark Souls 2 trained me never to give up and go somewhere else, because the game is almost entirely, well, okay, with certain enormous caveats, large sections of the game are highly linear, but they're also highly achievable. It's more loopy than linear, but you can do anything if you try hard enough in that game. As in this game, I think. And so when I fail to do something, I obviously jump straight to, well, I'm obviously not trying hard enough. Oh wow, two of them got called up this time, but then they go back down again. Yeah, the body falling on it must have disturbed them. I guess a corpse falling on my head would disturb me too. I'm going around this way to be safe. Alright. How close do I have to get for the scuttler to scuttle? There he is. There he goes. But it's too late. Oh, shit. No, it's not shit. It's, I think I can run. Cool. So, time to not make all the same mistakes as before. I may have to make some of the mistakes, you understand. It's quite difficult to avoid every mistake. That was the mistake of rolling into the guy. Did that one again. It's quite hard to parry that weapon, even though it looks like it's a slow raise overhead thing. Ah, very good. This is interference. Look at that guy. I don't even need the Phantasm Shell if I'm going to actually succeed at parries. It's great for bosses though. Then again, so are other hunter tools that use bullets. So you've got trade-offs. Birds. I see you. I didn't see you. I insist on defeating this enemy. I can't just not win. I could, actually, but it would be unprofessional. Fuck! I got it and then I didn't do it. What a dumb person, me. Good. Oh, Okay, I got a tempering dump, damp blood gem and whatever this is. It's a beast hunter sight. Well, that sounds cool. Vermin? Root of man's impurity rives within filth. The League. This is the thing Vatla wanted me to join. The League has assumed the task of finding and crushing all vermin. Mercy in the madness. Those who wish to see vermin can, and those who choose to are provided with boundless purpose. Yeah, no thanks. That sounds to me like it's something they're making up, essentially. The root of man's impurity. I doubt it. The root of man's impurity is man. That sounds like an appropriate thing to say for this genre. The root of man's impurity is man himself. Okay. I'm really running out, I think, of capability to progress in this place, but let's give it a bit more of a shot. River of blood. Nothing here, seemingly. Oh, no, there's... Oh, no. Oh, no. It's one of the kin giants. I may not make it to see that bloody sun. So, if you don't remember, I killed one of these guys. What? That's different. What? This multiple. I've been rused. Bloodborne has rused me. Why did I jump into that? I didn't quite understand how it worked. Wow. So I'm just gonna run past here, because there's another one behind me, I'm pretty sure. Okay, I'm gonna keep running until I have a reason to stop. Okay. So the bad news is, I think there were like two giants there. The good news is you can just ignore them. I may go back and kill them at some point. Oh, wow. It's a flayed skeletal zombie creature. I feel like I should probably put that out of its misery. 5 blood vials. Can't have been in that much misery then. Wow. Giants. Unfortunately, I think there was a side path there, which I may have to fight them to get to. This is ominous. Pebbles! Where did that come from? Pipes! I should have known where there's a pebble, there's a witch. So, these blood giants, kin giants, whatever they are, I see stairs over there. Could I run behind him and go up into that building? That's a maybe. Let's try it out. The maybe is rapidly becoming a yes. There are other places to go, but this is one of them. A sarcophagus which has been slid aside, and a lamp. Nice. I gotta say, having a lamp right next to the giants makes it considerably more likely that I will ever attempt to defeat both of them at the same time. Oh, it's one of these things. I want to get it. Down. chunks. This is an analogue of the sewers, and there's a shadow there of someone who's going to jump down on me. Let's leave that alone for now. Hey, I recognize this. Henriette. I remember Henriette. She was totally useless. Still, I may summon her once again. But not right now, because right now what I'm thinking is, I've found a lamp. This is, you know, my progress through the Hunter's Nightmare is saved at this point. I might leave it alone for now. I just want to explore in a couple of directions, see if there were some passages that I vaguely noticed while running around. Whether they were real. Oh! Goodbye. Oh shit, yeah, there's an axe giant and a gun giant. Nice, nice, nice. So the other giant came from over here, right? Oh, but there isn't a path there. I guess I thought there was one. Huh. Where then? Ah, that's where... I'm pointing at the screen. I you can't see the point, I know. Their faces are so tentacly. Probably not getting that blood money back, but I want to get into that side path. Ideally, I'm not going to try and kill these giants right now. I will try to go around them more effectively, more sagaciously and wisely than I have to date. Although this first one I could probably get a stab off on. No, I probably couldn't really. Well, let's find out. Didn't work. Okay, let's run away. Wow. I wonder where my blood money did go. One of them will have picked it up. Yeah, so that's useless. Okay, my system is rolling. There it is. There's where I wanted to go. That's the path. I didn't do it. Let's make another attempt. If I'm about to depart the Hunter's Nightmare for a while, I should do so in full knowledge of what I am eschewing. Where should I go other than the Nightmare? There's two obvious places. One is to continue on the path after the Amygdala Door and the Cathedral Ward. Into an area which actually claimed to be Yahagul, which was interesting because I thought I'd been to Yahagul. Maybe it's a different part of Yahagul. I don't know. Unfortunately, it's in the way of where I want to go. Well, let's just change where I am. Gosh. Cool. There's something here. Butcher gear. Nice. I got your stuff, and I'm alive. Might make it back. It's possible anyway. Yeah. They take up these positions. Go. So this time I know there's a witch here somewhere. Near the pebbles. Right. There it is. Wait, there's a bird. Wait, it's two birds. I've been repeatedly incorrect. Kill this. Oh. Wow, I got you. You're not getting my eyeballs today. This poor, sad soul who carries an enormous amount of valuable healing items. It's my duty to ease their pain. And by doing so, go on to ease my own. So, here's a super ominous passage. Should I go in this direction? Maybe? I'd like to see what happens, at least. I bet what happens is this door slams shut and I have a boss fight.
Help us.
did.
Have mercy upon us.
Ugh. This was the fate of Ludwig. Like it's unfortunate, and like it's not gonna happen to me. Whatever it takes, Silas will not become one of those beasts. Oh, did you see how much hit points that blow took off him? Not very many. I'm gonna grab this now. Oh. I wonder if he's got a weak spot or something. Man, that's horrific. Ludwig the Accursed. I will leave you he be in the Hunter's Nightmare. I wonder if Ludwig, he was one of the earliest, he was the first of the church hunters, founded the church workshop, the healing church workshop. I wonder if it's his nightmare. I wonder if that's what this guy implied, power of this guy. Ah, I'm not where that guy is anymore. Well, powerful forces were said to be in favor of keeping the secrets here hidden. Is that because Ludwig the famous, the holy, as in Ludwig's holy blade, ended up as that thing? Oh, right, yes, I've already come out here. Okay then. That is enough of the Hunter's Nightmare for now. I will be returning to the main game. It's tough, it's cool, but it's not easy. And I would like to give myself more training before I return to progress. Ludwig seems like he's gonna be quite something.